Welcome to part 3 of the video series. Today we're looking at 4 different ways to accept payments with Google Forms. In part 1, we showed you how to add a PayPal link in the Google Forms confirmation page after your customer submitted their order. We have also seen the problems that come with that approach. In part 2, we discussed how to build a PayPal link with a dynamically calculated total so that your customers can click on it and pay the correct amount. Of course, there is still the problem of manual reconciliation of payment and orders. Here in part 3, I'm going to show you how to send a PayPal link automatically pre-filled with calculated totals when someone submits an order in your Google Form. To watch the other parts of the series, please refer to the links in the description box below. Subscribe to this channel for more videos and tips for your order forms. Okay, let's get started. We'll now go back to Elaine, who had a successful start to her handmade scented candle business 5 weeks ago. Let's join her today to see how she has improved her Google Forms to send email notifications to her customers about their orders. She sends the PayPal link pre-filled with the exact amount to pay for their bulk orders along with those emails so that it will be easy for them to pay her. Elaine expands her business to local associations and other companies. She offers to prepare gift sets with an assortment of candle fragrances. As the holiday season approaches, she expects bulk orders to come in, so there needs to be a way to mention the quantity of each of the candle types. In the Google Form, she changes the questions where she's listed her candles. Now it reads, how many coffee bean candles, gift sets? She changes the description to add the new pricing of the gift set, $50 for a set of 3 fragrances. Hazelnut, coffee, caramel, and cafe latte, and espresso cinnamon. She also changes the question type from multiple choice questions to short answer questions so that her users can type in the number of gift sets required. She makes sure to keep the price format intact as the currency symbol first and then the price. Remember, she uses Neartail add-on for dynamic total calculations. It requires this pricing format to be correctly mentioned in the question description. She makes similar changes to the other candle listing as well. After these changes are made, she checks again to see if the dynamic calculations are intact or needs any changes. Next, she clicks on the add-on icon, selects Neartail, selects Customize this form option, and Customize. In the Neartail Customize interface, she scrolls all the way down and clicks on the gear icon next to the short answer question for the total amount. On the sidebar, the field settings screen is displayed. She clicks on the answer tab, and yes, the total formula that she wrote earlier to calculate the total of the order amount dynamically is still there. She previews the form to submit a test order. She enters 1 quantity of each gift set, so the total calculated is $90. It's like magic, isn't it? Have you taken a look at the PayPal link below? Remember how she added the dynamic amount to the URL last time? Now, that changes too. It will help her customers to pay from it directly like last time. This time, Elaine sends this form to the local businesses and associations for bulk orders, so that she doesn't expect them to pay immediately. Once she receives a bulk order, she's planning to send an order summary via email and the payment link along with it. This way, her customers can also have the details for their records and can process the payments accordingly. Now that she has the totals automatically calculated, she wants to set up automatic email notifications, which will show the name, the email, and the summary of the order along with the PayPal link. Once again, she checks in Google Workspace Marketplace to look if there are any add-ons that can help her set up email notifications. She searches for customized confirmation email with form response. She finds the Mailrecipe add-on, which says send a customized confirmation email with the form response and additional instructions. The Mailrecipe add-on is also from the same company that developed Neartail. She can't be more excited than this. She goes ahead and installs the Mailrecipe add-on. On the Google Form, she clicks on the add-on icon, Mailrecipe, then notify users by email. Since she already has the email address captured in her Google Form, it automatically selects it for who should receive the email notification. She clicks on Next. She changes the email subject and proceeds. On the next screen, she sees a default email message body, ready to share the summary of the customer's orders. The format is this. You can customize this email message and include any of the form fields by clicking on the Add field from the top right of the screen. She changes the email body. At the end of the email, she includes her PayPal Me link. Like she did earlier in part 2 of the video series, she wants to add the total amount field value to the end of the PayPal link. She keeps the cursor at the end of the link and clicks on the Add field dropdown to pick the total amount field. It adds the form field ID, which starts with entry, followed by a big number within a dollar symbol and curly braces. If you are already aware of the Google Forms pre-fill feature, you might have noticed that this is Google Forms' way of identifying each form field. After saving this setting, she previews it to test whether it works in real time. Since she has both the Neartail and Mailrecipe add-ons set up in the same form, Neartail dynamically calculates the order total and Mailrecipe uses it within the email notification. She places a test order with her own email ID and submits it. And ta-da! She receives an email that has the order summary and the PayPal link pre-filled with the exact amount as the order total. Isn't that amazing? The notification is helpful for her customers to have a record of what they just ordered, and it'll be easy for her customers to pay the right amount without many manual mistakes. But again, the manual verification is still on Elaine. Like we saw in part 1 and part 2 of the video series, she has to go through the same pain of reconciliation of customer and payment records. That reconciliation problem doesn't go away for her. But what if the corporate customers did not want to pay via PayPal? What if they want to do it with the credit card? Stay tuned for the next part where we answer these questions. In part 4 of this video series and the final video, I'll show you how to integrate Stripe within Google Forms, allow your customers to pay without leaving the Google Form, and automatically get the payment reference recorded in the Google Form itself. That'll surely put an end to the payment reconciliation problem. See you there!